So, you know that feeling when you're playing a game and something just goes wrong? There's some unexpected scenario where your player falls through the floor, unexpectedly die, or reach somewhere you weren't supposed to. One of the most famous of these unexpected features is the backwards long jump in Super Mario 64, where Mario can build up infinite negative velocity when jumping backwards. The developers only checked if his speed was less than a certain value, so if Mario was moving backwards, his speed was negative, so it would always be less than a specific value no matter how fast he was going. These bugs left in developers can sometimes be harmless, like how horses walk up cliffs in Skyrim, lead to unexpected scenarios like Mario's backwards long jump, or be game-breaking like the corrupted blood plague in World of Warcraft. In some games, they can be even worse and lead to security exploits or arbitrary code execution. One of the best ways to avoid these types of errors from getting into a game is to provide adequate testing. I'm sure everyone's familiar with playtesting for a game. Sometimes games will even launch an alpha or beta version that's specifically not ready for the general public and is meant to test out specific features. Some games, like Subnautica, even added a way to report and visualize where players hit bugs or pain points to improve the game experience. This kind of player feedback and testing is very important to ensuring that a game feels right and keeping the overall number of bugs to a minimum. Although, there is another kind of testing in addition to playtesting. While playtesting may help us designing a game, ensuring a game works with basic functional testing is another category and is useful for any type of software development. While you might want to playtest to ensure that a player's movement feels right and adjusting parameters, basic functional testing ensures that the code for the character controller works as expected. Functional testing assures that the code functions as expected. A very basic functional test for a character could be walking into a wall and ensuring that they don't clip through the wall. Although, when working with complex software with a lot of moving parts, testing can sometimes be overlooked. And since these projects tend to be very large and complex, changing one part may affect something else you had written previously. As an example, let's say you want to write a feature to apply gravity to a player when they are not standing on the ground. Works fine, and the player falls to the ground. Develop some other stuff, forget about the original feature of gravity when the player is not standing on the ground. Later, you add another feature so that the player will jump when they hit spacebar. You test it out, and it works fine. However, you forget to apply gravity when the player is not holding spacebar, so they can now jump forever. You find this after some manual testing, but it took time to fix the bug, and it was really embarrassing when you showed off the project to your friends. To avoid social embarrassment and make sure this never happens again, you vow to test every feature whenever you add a new feature. However, now you must repeat the same testing, running into a wall, jumping and falling, over and over and over again. Good thing for you, there's a solution to this kind of problem. Automation. As I always say, why do something in 10 minutes when you can spend 10 hours automating it? Although you can't automate playtesting how a game feels, you can automate running into a wall at 100 slightly different angles. With testing, there's usually basic types of tests, unit and integration tests. Unit tests involve evaluating if each individual unit is working as expected. So, does a player fall when they are not under the ground? Does the player jump when they hit spacebar? Integration test evaluates if different components of the code work together. When the player hits spacebar, do they go up and then down, following the jump and gravity rules? The way that these tests work in Unity is through two main types. One, edit mode tests that are great for unit testing features, and two, play mode tests that simulate playing the game and are great for integration testing features. The edit mode tests are very lightweight and run quickly, while the play mode tests take quite a bit longer to run and require more overhead. Unity has some nice panels for tracking, executing, and measuring these test coverage. If you want to see an example, feel free to check out the example repo I linked in the description. Now, for my entirely hypothetical, and not at all happened to me in my kinematic character controller project, I have added a feature that allows the character to walk upstairs and detect if it's walking into a step. However, this piece of code is a bit complicated and requires a few checks to work properly. When I was adding a new feature to have the player follow moving platforms, I was so happy to add the new feature, I pushed the build to my website so it could show it off to my friends the next day. Unfortunately, adding that moving platform script broke the other stair script, and I failed to test all these features before finishing up for the night. Then, when I showed it off to my friends, they saw the moving platforms, thought they were pretty cool, but then noticed that the character just couldn't walk upstairs for some reason. Upon looking into the code, I found that the code I wrote to handle moving platforms broke the stair code and it would take some time to fix. So, yeah, that's when I decided I should probably write some tests for those features and wrote up testing for all the features in my project over the next few weeks. I automated those tests so that I couldn't forget to run them at some time in the future. Great! Now that I have these automated tests, I can easily verify that new changes don't break old features. It took a bit of time to write the test for all permutations of stairs and running into walls at various speeds and angles. This means that I know these test features will always meet this baseline of performance. However, this doesn't guarantee that you will never shoot yourself in the foot. Some complex combinations of changes in the future could pass those tests, but still not quite run as expected. So, it's still possible to shoot yourself in the foot, but adding a good set of integration unit tests will help verify that your changes work as expected. For example, I added tests where the players can walk down, up and down a set of stairs to the second floor and down to the ground. As long as this test passes, I can be fairly sure that it will work. Now, writing tests can take quite a bit of time, and there is a case to skip writing some tests. For example, the developer Celeste specifically didn't write some tests and documentation for their character controller when they shared their design because they knew they would be constantly updating and tweaking it over development. So, for them, they did the math and came to the conclusion that the cost of constantly writing and adjusting tests for the character controller that would be changing frequently wasn't worth the extra effort. On the other hand, my OpenKCC library is meant to be used in many projects under many scenarios. So since I'm sharing this project with others, it would be expected that any features I provide in my documentation are tested and verified. And the process of manually verifying them is prone to error, so I make sure to write automated tests. Hopefully you have some more knowledge and appreciation for how you can test software and video games. Feel free to investigate my OpenKCC repo if you want to see some examples of automated testing in Unity. All software development is about balancing time, resources, and quality. Testing can help improve quality, but takes extra resources and time. Depending on the requirements of your project, you may need to adjust what is tested in the project and how that testing is done. Some bugs slip through are acceptable as long as they don't compromise the quality of the product. Good luck developing your future projects, and have a great day!